Hey, that worked.
How's everybody? Shaun Allen here. Another day, another vlog. Yes, as you can see, I'm at Universal Studios Hollywood. Still closed. So, this update is once again at Universal Citywalk, which is right over here to my left. More shops have opened, plus brand new merchandise is being sold right now at the Universal Studios store, featuring some old retro rides that are no longer at Universal Studios Hollywood. Actually, there's one in particular that is still there to this day. Instead of me just spoiling everything, why don't we just show you what I'm talking about? This is gonna be a lot of fun. Once again, starting out this vlog right over here by the physical distancing sign. It also mentions to wash your hands, use face coverings, and avoid contact with people who are sick. So after a few weeks of it being closed, Billabong is open. Doors are open. You got to see this place up and running again. So this is one shop that is currently open that was not open last time I was here. Universal Studios store is still open at this time. We still have the Secret Life of Pets attraction merchandise as well as advertisements up here. Entrance only. And of course, you got to use the hand sanitizer. Oops. Oh, there it goes. Took it a second. And here it is, guys. This is the new merchandise that is being sold right now, featuring stuff from the old retro Universal Studios Hollywood. The classic Universal Studios Hollywood logo. Here's the shirt right here. We got E.T. There's Back to the Future, the ride. Frankenstein Monster. King Kong or Confrontation. Earthquake. And Jaws. Now, out of all these things, King Kong, E.T., and Back to the Future are gone. Jaws and Earthquake, they're still there, but this is still around, but as 360 3D. This is interesting because this actually is the Orlando version. If you guys don't remember, there was a ride called Confrontation, or the King Kong ride, where the Revenge of the Mummy attraction is now. This used to be an attraction over there in Orlando, where you used to get into a kind of like a, I guess in a way, a trolley type vehicle. We also have car coasters here as well as magnets. There's E.T. right there. Got a sweatshirt, a banner, and some nice socks. Stuff for the ladies. Oh, we got a fanny pack there. Oh, we got a poster. I might pick one of these up. This looks pretty cool. And then we have a signed Michael J. Fox Sports Almanac replica. That is cool. Back to the Future hat. The hoverboard, which is signed by Michael J. Fox. And Doc Brown and Marty McFly right there signing this picture from Back to the Future 1. We also have the masks here too. Check these out. These are cool. Universal Studios Hollywood masks. We have these cool pouches here too. And on the lanyard here it says, "See the stars, ride the movies." That's actually really neat. I like those. Well, guys, I got a few things while I was in the store. I had to because, you know, I do work for Universal. Plus, this is a pretty cool occasion because, you know, it's not very often you get to see merchandise that has Back to the Future anymore, especially the ride. But I got a few things. First thing I got was the shirt. The cost of it was 30 bucks. Kind of expensive, but since this is for a limited time, you know, it kind of makes sense. Then I got the poster. I actually have an area where I can put this up in my room. That is a really, really neat poster right there. And I actually got one of the Universal Studios Hollywood masks. They have two different sizes. There's one that's a medium and there's one that's also a large. So right there, these are $8, or $8 each. So again, I'm gonna try out the large. This is an adult large. They also had a medium, but I got a large. So I'm gonna very quickly transition from this mask to the Universal Studios Hollywood mask and see what the difference is like. Obviously it's gonna be a lot different because you got this part here that goes up around the nose. This is like your typical standard like mask. Oh, this is actually a much lighter material. Yeah, it's really, really thin. Really thin. Got the Universal Studios Hollywood logo right there. Take that off very quickly. Hey, not too bad. Oh, I can actually speak a lot better now. Yeah, this material is actually really, really thick. I have a different one. You guys have probably seen me wear the other one that has the Hollywood one. It's basically like felt or fabric. The Hollywood one, this is very, very, very thin. Which is probably better because that way you can hear what I'm saying. But this one, it's like this, you know? So this is actually really nice. It's really soft. You know, you could probably smell a little bit of the polyester in it, but that's okay. It's still really nice. Yeah, I think I went with the right size for the large because I got a large mouth. I'm big mouth, duh. Oh, and the shirt? What do you think? It's pretty cool, right? I think it's pretty neat. This is a really neat shirt. This one is too. This is my Fast and Furious Supercharged one, but still, whoops. It's pretty cool. But for today, we're wearing this one. Yeah. As I mentioned a couple of weeks ago, since we're getting the new season of baseball coming in for the summer, I kind of figured, hey, the Dodgers clubhouse should be opening soon, and lo and behold, I was right. Dodgers clubhouse is open. Still waiting on people in Italian kitchen. Look at a restaurant. I like these grapevines too. Oh look, right there, those are a group of grapes right there. That is a grapevine. But that's so cool, you can actually see the grapes right there. There's more. Very cool. This is the location for it. It's Sugar, but as you can see in the windows here, it's completely blacked out. They say, sorry we missed you. See you soon. But you know what? I am seeing guests with bags from It's Sugar, so it probably means they moved back to their old location. Well, no word yet about Nectar Bath Treats. Hopefully it will be opening up soon, but it's closed, unfortunately. And Sparky's is also closed along with Mini Donuts. However, and Tajitos, it is open for business. Ooh, I like this. They actually extended their seating area. They have it out here as well. That's really a good idea. Gets the extra spacing and more social distancing and more seats. That is really good. We got these nice umbrellas. Put them in the shade. Really cool. So Antojitos is also open for business. Ooh, check it out. I think they just put up the sign here for NBC Grill and Brew. That is new. Taste the victory. That is awesome. Can't wait to see this place up and running. That'd be really, really cool. Wow. After months of having this whole place barricaded off, and even till last year with all the wood and all, right up here, it is officially open, guys, with all the new stuff here. Check that out. They've got new signs up. Remember those wooden, like, they look like wooden crates in the front here? Those are all gone. And I love, oh yeah, they did add a third, no, fourth sign. Nice. It is, oh my goodness, that is so cool. Can't wait to go inside. It's Sugar, it is open. Here we go. We are inside, guys, and look at this. The yellow brick road is now a yellow brick, actually say yellow beans, jelly beans. It's the Wizard of Oz. We got Dorothy, the Scarecrow, the Tin Man, and the Cowardly Lion. They're completely made of jelly beans, except for their faces, but still, that is awesome. There's no place like It's Sugar. That is so cool. You know, many years ago, they used to have something like this, but it was with Marilyn Monroe. She was made of entirely of jelly beans. Nice job. Wow. So this used to be Stranger Things themed. Like, remember all the trees and stuff that were over here? That's all gone now. Well, the witch is dead. The Wicked Witch is dead, at least one of them. Yellow Brick Road, Emerald City, Poppy Fields. Oh, we don't want to go there. And Munchkin Land, the Sour Patch Kids, and Swedish Fish. Love the props too, wow. Oh my goodness, look at all these lollipops. I'm a sucker for suckers. Man, this is like, they really did a fantastic job with this. Look at this. Red M&M right over here. Every year they always play the Christmas one. And that's been going on for years, him when they meet up with Santa Claus. Oh, here they are. This is looking amazing. Found the giant gummy stuff. There's giant pickles, gummy donuts, and the burger. There it is, the one and only giant gummy bears. And a giant gummy snake. Oh yeah, the giant cola bottle. And the worm! Okay, alright. That was actually really good. I like the way that they
redesigned that whole area. Wow, they really put a lot of work into that place.
Got some more seating over here. Very cool. Like, if there's no seating up there, you definitely come down here and eat as well. They're obviously spaced out for social distancing, and since they're not really doing any movies at the moment, you can sit out here in the front, which honestly is not a bad idea, because there's not that much seating up there, especially right now. So having the seats out here, especially with these umbrellas, it's a good idea. Whoa. This front part here of where the good old... Oh, Hard Rock Cafe. I forgot what was in here for a second. That whole section here, the front, is completely gone. They're making way for the Chocolate Emporium. Toothsome Chocolate Emporium. We'll be heading off in this direction in a little bit. But first, we gotta say hello to everybody. Ah, things from another world. Please wear a face mask and social distancing in effect. Here we go.
Oh boy, I knew this was gonna happen. They brought the child from the Mandalorian here. And still to this day, by the time I'm recording this video, I still have not seen the Mandalorian. Wow, they got a lot more action figures. There's Wonder Woman, and Batman, and Superman. We got the Batman who laughs right there. Cool. More DC stuff. Oh, there's Batgirl. Ooh, they got Thanos. Ben and Flex Thanos and the Hulk. Got a lot of Deadpool and Squirrel Girl. And they got the comics this week right here. Little Harley Quinn. Ooh, Marvel's right there. Very cool. Since I'm here at Things Under the World, I can't forget about... Oh, I forgot to say hello to Iron Man. Oh, well. But I'm here to say hello to Batman and, of course, Harley Quinn. And speaking of Batman, I actually brought something with me, because I'm going to do a little quick photo with this guy very quickly. I brought along with me this guy. Yes, it looks very similar to that because it's from the Arkham games. This particular action figure from Batman. You got the Raiders image open. Oh, lids, it's open. It's the hat shop. Right next door is the sandal shop. Unfortunately, that's not open. We also got Voodoo Donuts all the way down here. That was one of the first things that opened when Citywalk reopened. Minchies is still... Oh, it's open. Sweet. Minchies is open. Nice to see they're back up and running. And look, Pineapple Float. Very cool. So we got Minchies up and running. Getting up to the second level is making a clicking sound, kind of like the Jurassic World ride when you're going up the side. So Subway is open. Panda Express, unfortunately, is not. The Habit will be coming soon, as it says right there. Look at that cheeseburger, double cheeseburger. Wow. Pulp Bar is still closed, unfortunately, but Taco Bell is also open, as well as KFC and Pizza Hut. And Pink's is open. Very cool. It's really nice out here today. And I'm actually walking by another seating area that you can also sit down and eat. And by the way, I know that some of you are probably asking me, Shaun, you took off your mask last time when you were sitting down over here. Was that really necessary? Yes, because you can do that if you're sitting down at these tables. If you're sitting down here to eat, talk to somebody, you're more than welcome to sit down and leave your mask off. Just need to make sure you put it back on before you leave. I asked a team member about that. They said absolutely. So I was in the right, basically. Whew. Getting some good exercise, though, I can tell you that. And that's your update from Universal Citywalk, folks. I hope you enjoyed it. If you liked it, hit the thumbs up button. It is greatly appreciated. I know I should have done this in order to get me back home, the snapping of the fingers and all that. I guess I was just a little tired when I got back, so I forgot to record it. But, you know, it is what it is. But in case you're wondering, I decided for this particular vlog, or update I should say, I guess it is a vlog, I wanted to showcase the shops that were not open from last week. So that's what I basically focused on for this video. I know that the Universal Studios Store and Things of the World were open last week, but I still wanted to show them anyway. Obviously, the Universal Studios Store, because they had new merchandise, I had to show that off. Things of the World, you know me, I like comics, I like stuff from there. So anyways, guys, thank you again for watching this video. If you liked it, once again, hit the thumbs up button. If you want to see more of my content, be sure to check out my other videos, as well as my other channels, the Educational Series, the Design Video Series, and the Travel Town Series. You can find me on Instagram, the link is down below, in the description of this video, as well as my PO Box address. Alright guys, thank you so much for watching. And as they say in Hollywood, still not in Hollywood, I'm at home. I was in Hollywood in this vlog. That, my friends, is a wrap. See you tomorrow.